shortly after the murder of my son on December 24th of 2011. And what the Howard Huskies do is we house young men. We've taken over the Old Noble Motel in East Cleveland, part of the revitalization program here. And we also travel and play different universities in football. We have Ashland on our schedule this year, Washington Jefferson College, and we're traveling to Fort Lauderdale to play IMG Academy, so that's a pretty big deal. We're going back to play the Navy and other universities as well. We have partners with Byron Wallace, the Riddoff Group, and other organizations that's going to provide wraparound services for our young men this year, so I'm very, very grateful. So we're here. We are here. We are here. Welcome and thank you so much for coming out. So all of my gentlemen, all of my football players, I want you to get centered with me right now. Get focused and get centered. I want you to get focused and get centered.
Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface looks warm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth. Jackson, the words won't I come out, and he's choking how. Everybody's choking now, the clock's run out. Time's up, snap back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity, oh, there goes gravity.
The words.
He's so mad, but
listen,
he won't
to what he has to say. He won't have it, he knows
he's ropes. It don't matter, he's dope. He knows that, but he's pro. He's so stagnant, he knows when he goes back to his mobile home.
Don't go back. Back to the don't go back to where you came from.
You better go capture this moment and hope it
happens. Capture his
weapons. Lose yourself. Hey, hey. It's
your moment.
Get one shot. Do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime.
It's your first lifetime opportunity. What you gonna do?
You better never let it go.
Get grounded. Get grounded now. Right now, you can do what you want. Right now, come on.
It only grows harder, only grows hotter. He blows, it's all over. These hoes is all on him. Coast to coast shows, he's known as the Globetrotter. Lonely roads got him. He knows his grown father. From home, he's no father. He goes home and barely knows his own.
You better know what you know.
See, it goes to cold water. These hoes don't want him no more. He's cold.
Well, if you go back, old news. All news if you go back doing what you did. The beat goes on and let up the left die. Come on! Your grind is on now. Get your grind on now, fellas. Because if you go home and work at McDonald's and Roddy, you ain't gonna get back on that, and your mama not gonna take care of you no more. This is your life. Let's go, you on the move. Don't stay in one spot, you on the move. I would like to take this time to tell you all, parents, thank you, and we are honored and humbled that you chose the Howard Huskies prep program. So thank you very much. We have a lot of great partners here that will be working with your children, as we talked about on the parent meeting. We have our Urban Empowerment Outreach, Baldwin Waters College. We have author James Wingo here today. Remember, everyone must purchase the book because we're going to do a great reading program with author Wingo. There are many more, and you can individually speak to individual partners here. They will acknowledge themselves. Please, partners of mine, lift your hands up. Julie is so humble, you guys, but that's Miss Julie right there from Baldwin Waters University. So we're gonna thank you. Now, I would like to call up Mr. Charles C., who is gonna give you guys a word of confidence and wisdom. Mr. C.
Good afternoon. How is everybody?
Good.
All right. You're looking good. Just had a few words of encouragement that I wanted to offer to the group here. And I'm delighted to have this opportunity to take my glasses off so we can see each other. Thank you very much. You know, when your daughter introduces you, you can always count on a pretty gracious introduction. And that's my daughter, Monica. Thank you for that. I'm glad to be here with you this afternoon and share with you this particular convivial occasion which brings us all here together. I'm going to bring personal greetings, as I said, to my daughter, Veronica, who's the First Lady of the Howard Huskies, as well as to Coach Howard and the other coaches that are part of this awesome organization. James Howard, the coach, for me, is a man for all seasons. And the other coaches and the entire staff of the Huskies organization, they are a remarkable group of individuals, which some of you already know, and those of you who don't will be finding out shortly. Every successful organization has a supportive staff, which is the backbone of that operation. The Huskies organization is certainly no exception. Behind the scenes, working to make every day a good day for you students, you find a well-oiled machine, an exceptional staff who dot I's and cross T's. They want to make sure that everything you Huskies need, you're going to get you so you can be successful on the field as well as off the field. And being successful and working together, young men, as I'm sure you already know, you gotta be on the same page, you gotta coordinate, you gotta make sure that the left hand knows what the right hand is doing. And as a young man, I learned that the hard way. So I was in high school, I remember I was in high school, and there was about four of us. I ran with three other guys, James Beckett, and Chunky Batty, and his brother, Rick. And we went down to, we had an English class taught by Little Bell Johnson. And you didn't want to be late to Little Bell's class, you just wanted to be late to her class. And so we went up to Jane Adams at that time, girls. And we messed around and we were watching the games and the girls. And look at our watch. But they didn't get to play. And man, Little Bell didn't play late. So we were coming down the hall and she said, "Gentlemen, you're late." I said, "Don't worry." I got you. I said, "Well, Miss Johnson, you know how you always told us that you see somebody in a dire need, you should stop them, you should help them. So we saw an elderly gentleman who needed his tire changed, so we stopped and we changed his tire for him. She said, did you? I tell you what you need. She said, Charlotte, you go down to the north, Tommy, you go down to the south, Foster, you go in the west corner, and James, you go in the east corner. Gentlemen, pull out your pencils and your pad, yeah. And I want you to write down what tire it was you had to change. So you can see, being on the same page and understanding what the left hand was doing and what the right hand was doing can be very important, particularly when you got to report out about your activities. Please allow me to take a moment. I want to publicly thank Monica Howard and James Howard for their vision, for their dedication, for their tenacity, for love, for assistance. They, along with the others who support the Howard Huskies program, have made this program possible for you and your children. They do this in honor of their son, JJ, and my grandson. They build an institution that cultivates the grit and the talent that you young man give, that you're going to share, that you're going to come to achieve, and the things that you're going to aspire towards, they're going to be dedicating themselves to make that happen. We've often heard it said that no man is an island. Well, that's also true about the football dynasty, like the Huskies. They cannot be a great institution without the partnership that they have, and we've heard some of those partnerships mentioned. Bowling Wallace University, the Riddall Group, the Urban Empowerment Outreach Group, and many others. You've heard it takes an entire village to raise a child, and all these extraordinary people and community resources are working together for one purpose, for you, the 2022 Howard Huskies, to represent the very best, and represent the very best talent, character, and intellect that's going to be on the gridiron come this season. Welcome, young men, to Howard JJ's village. I need a couple of volunteers. I need two volunteers. But you gotta be smart though. I need two young men. Let me see your hands. Let everybody see me once. I need two volunteers. All right, I see the young man back there. All right, I need two volunteers. There's one. Come on up, young fella. I need another. Where's he at?
Right here.
Oh, yeah, come on, young fella. I need a couple of volunteers. Where's my other volunteer at? Behind you, all right. All right, he looks like he's going to be for the first volunteer. All right, on the table here, for my volunteer, I have several coins. Tell them what those coins are. You gotta speak up.
A dime, a quarter, and a penny.
So you got a penny, a dime, a quarter, a dollar bill, and a $5 bill. I want to give you an opportunity. I see you the first volunteer. Your name again? The first volunteer, I'm gonna make you the main volunteer. You get a chance to choose one of these. You're going to be what we call the designated thinker. Ladies and gentlemen, you all will be designated thinkers. All right, join with me so we repel this rain here. All right, you're going to be designated. You're going to be designated thinker. What they want you to think about it. And ladies and gentlemen, you remember what's on the table. A dime, a penny, a dollar, a $5 bill, and a dollar bill. So I want you to give him some advice. Which one of these should he be choosing? If you talk to him, which one of these should he choose? Take a look at him. Basically, you know there's counterfeit money in it. Sure you do. So take a look at them, make sure they're not counterfeit. Ladies and gentlemen, you in the office, the dime, which one should he choose? Should he choose the dime? Should he choose the penny? Should he choose the quarter? Should he choose the dollar? Should he choose the $5 bill? Let him know. Shout out. Let him know what they got. He's examining them. He's looking for the fake if there's one there. Have we got one there? Anybody? Any takers there?
What's the money going towards?
He gets to keep. He gets
what's going towards?
He gets to keep whatever
that's
he
only objective?
Say again?
That's only objective?
Yeah, he gets to keep whatever he chooses. He gets to keep. All right. Okay. Anybody give me any other advice?
Scratch the collar.
Anybody else? Uh-oh.
Scratch the collar. If it's rigid, it's real.
Oh, look at it. Now that's it. You see what they're doing there? They're examining it carefully. They're taking a look at it. They're looking over the choices. They're seeing what's going on there. All right. Tick-tock, tick-tock, tick-tock.
$5 had a grid on it.
It's time to choose. Which one do you want? He chose the $5 bill. That's a smart young man. Let's give him a round of applause. All right, take the seat, son. You get to keep the rest of it because you helped him out. That's true. All right, thank you very much. Good morning to you.
Anything.
All right. Let's take a look at what we just witnessed. First thing we saw, we had a situation that presented itself, the money and the options. The second thing, a situation that had to be assessed, had to give some thought to it, had to make some determinations and some thinking and some decisions about what you were going to do. Third, he had a friend with him that gave him some advice and counsel with him. And you all, as a supportive community, you thought about what was happening. In the end, a decision was made, and the greatest possible benefit was derived. As a result of collectively thinking about what was going on, being able to talk to your friends, giving you some advice, and then finally, at the end, you making a decision about what you felt you needed to do. All right, young folks, I need you to lean in to me now, because we're getting ready to have a real serious conversation about choice and about what you need to do in this life. Because as bright as your future is right now, there's danger lurking in the shadows. Say that word with me. Danger.
Danger.
There's danger lurking in the shadows. Waiting for you to loosen your grip on the goal line and fumble the ball by making a bad choice. Danger. These dangers come disguised in many forms. They come as drugs and alcohol, posing as a good time. Just one more drink. One more hit, one more shot before I go. That supposed good time can end in disaster. Beware, young man. Make the right choice. They come as situations where friends need you to come and help them sell the beef across town. Those kinds of things, that kind of danger, ends in emergency rooms, courtrooms, prison cells, or worse, in a cemetery. Beware, young man. Make the right choice. They come as low personal self expectations with an attitude of, if I could just get by, I can make it. But just getting by is like getting 3 yards when it's 4th and 5. If you don't expect the very best of yourself, you'll always perform below your potential. Beware, young man. Make the right choice. They come as fleeting weekend romances. They leave you with 18 years of responsibility. Some spontaneous fun can complicate your life and cost you the career that you've come to JJ's Village hoping to achieve. Beware, young man. Make the right choice. They come as hard heads that won't listen. They pose as shortcuts that promise success without the hard work that success requires. Beware, young man. Make the right choice. But each of you have already demonstrated a capacity to make the right choice because you're here. Howard Huskies has already identified you as winners. You've chosen to take charge of your life and be caused in the matter of your own success. You've dedicated your robust intellect, superior athletic ability, and personal grit to fulfill the dream of the life you want to live. The Howard Huskies personnel associated with this organization stand ready to assist you in every step of the way. The game is on, son. It's 1st and goal. The ball is in your hand. And what you decide next will impact the rest of your life. Make the right choice. Now for a word to the parents here this afternoon.
I got three words for you. You've done good. Your hard work, personal sacrifice, and unconditional love has brought your son to this moment. You believe in him. Your unwillingness to give up on him during those trying moments, the nights you waited up for him, the days you went to work for him, and all the prayers you offered for him has brought him to this moment. Some of them will go on to play, I'm looking around, for the NFL. Some will become scholars and teach others. Some will go into politics, become social service agents, or have a 9-to-5, work hard, support their families, and come back one day to volunteer in this very village here. Whatever they go on to do, they do because you first believed in them and stood by them so that they had an opportunity and a chance to exercise their own personal goals. Please take a moment, parents. Take a moment. Be present to yourself and be present to the person. And be very, very proud of yourself at this moment. You've made the right choice. As I take my seat, I want to read you the words of President John Longville, delivered at the 39th Annual Black Graduation. He read, he said, and I read, to dream with your eyes open, to be a visionary, to visualize your future, to visualize your goals and speak them into existence, to be creative and resourceful, to not always be led by blind faith, but to be proactive, driven, and motivated, to see what others may not see and not let their limited vision limit you, to believe in yourself and your destination even when you can't see it manifested. To dream with your eyes open is just that. Some people journey through life sleepwalking or daydreaming, while others fail to dream and or get distracted by making the wrong choice. Let me remind you, it takes but a moment. Do the right thing. Be alert. Stay attentive. Know exactly where you are, what's going on, and what your goals are. And party, I leave you with the instructive words of Sir Winston Leonard Spencer Churchill, the former Prime Minister of the United Kingdom. Regarding your goals, regarding your dreams, regarding your future, never give up. Never give up. Never give up. Make us proud, gentlemen. Godspeed.
Good afternoon. Hi, my name is Coach Howard. I'm here at HH Prep. We're into our second year. We're having a beautiful celebration today with our new facility. We're just so inspired and very happy to have the young men here today with us. We're going to be playing college football against very good competition. Our prize game this year is IMG Academy. The young men will be their second year at Tri-C Community College. We're continually growing. We're so very pleased that the city of East Cleveland has brought us on and has just put forth so much support into what we're trying to do. We're very happy to be a part of the revitalization of East Cleveland. Again, HH Prep, here to stay. God bless. Thank you.
Here comes the.
Y'all don't really want it like that.
Yeah. Here comes the.
So I keep big bills up in my hood on the dirty like Bledsoe. Ain't got no twist in my head, but I'm still dreadful. And I got plenty of bread, so I go to bed for a lot. In it to win it, to win it, I'm all in. I might call you my cousin, young blood, but we ain't kin. You think of jumping, man, you best think again. The dirty, I'm the type of man that might go broke for revenge. Had some not so nice friends, kick the dough off the hinge. Take the dough off your bins, pop up off all your friends. Man, please, this here ain't cynical. Man, no subliminal, I'm physical, financial, and mental to be a general. Hey, your mama claims she want a soldier. Not the type be in the tank, but in that rover. Man, please, I'm in the zone like AIDS full blown. I'm killing it like a blind man. Mary, I'm feeling it like, oh, yeah. Here comes the, oh, here comes the, oh, here comes the, y'all don't really want it, yeah, yeah. Here comes the, oh, here comes the, oh, here comes the, y'all don't really want it, yeah, yeah. Here comes the, oh, here comes the, oh, here comes the, y'all don't really want it, yeah, yeah. Here comes the, oh, here comes the, oh, here comes the, y'all don't really want it, yeah, yeah. Diggy, diggy, gutter, when he knew he saw his butter, he ain't never been a fighter. You can go and ask his mother. I'm a lover and a fighter. A fighter, producer and a writer. Give your girl a quick fix and give your man a nice shiner. You know y'all don't really want it. And I can tell just by looking at you that you decide to run and go and tell just by looking at you. You on a mission for recognition by dissing. Didn't have no problem till the record started breaking, but y'all don't really want it. So let me tell you the deal. I'm also serious. I'm dirty. I'm no longer for real. I'm like a hop, skip, and a jump. A clock grip on the pump. From leaving you in the trunk. Somewhere prepared to dump. But y'all don't really want it. So quit acting like you're dead. I'm looking to my right. Trying to see who's left. So hard. You better watch it before I stick to the plan. And be the next artist to run up in your stands. Like, boom.